Dear listeners, now we talk about the white flow testing, white box testing. And in the white box testing, the most important testing is the control flow testing. Actually, the white box testing is the code testing. Here we test the code of the program. And you know, in any code, we have two major components. In the perspective of testing, the one is the data. Data means the variables and the objects. And in the data testing, we test how the data is assigned to a variable and how the data changes with the passage of time. And for the control flow, we test how the control flows through the program. Say this is a code and we have written some lines of code. Normally the code flows from line to line, but sometimes the flow jumps on some statements, and those jumps are actually caused by the decision points. Those decision points may be the loops or if else statements or switch cases or break statements. So first of all, for control flow testing, we need to draw a control flow graph. So we'll draw a graph, and before drawing the graph, let us see what notations the graph has. The circle shows a process. A process may be one single statement, or a part of a statement, or more than one statement. So circle actually shows the process in the control flow graph. And the next is a decision point. The decision point is actually a point where the control has two or more than two choices. In case of if else statement, the control has two choices. And in case of switch case statement, that control has more than two choices, and in the case of if else statement, the code has only two choices. So in the code, when we come across a decision point, we see that we have more than one choice. So this is called a decision point. And the next notation after the decision point is the junction point. The junction point is a statement or line or point in the code where two arrows come into the circle. Actually, it happens when the control can come to the statement from two different paths. The junction point is actually a terminology that we also observe in motorways and in highways, where two roads meet on a single point, and we call it a junction point. So now let us see a sample code, and we will draw the control flow graph for this sample code. This sample code has this sample code has three statements, and after the fourth statement is actually a decision point where we have if and else, and then also another statement at the decision point at the end. So let's merge the first three statements as a single process where we are assigning the values to the variables. And then the next is a decision point. The you can recognize the decision point with the fact that the more than one arrows come out of the circles, and the junction point is the circle where more than one arrows come into the circle. So in this graph, you see two decision points. One is at the part of if, the first if, and the second is on the part of the other if. So instead of writing it this way, we can also assign numbers to the lines of the code, and then depending upon those line numbers, we can draw the control flow graph. So we are assigning numbers to the lines of to the code statement and so this is the first line, second line, third line, and the fourth line is actually at scene point where more than one arrows will come out of the circle, because here we have two choices. In case of if true, we will go to line number 5, and in case of false, we will go to the line number 6, and 5 and 6, the arrows from 5 and 6 will come to a single circle. So as more than one lines merge into the statement number 7, so statement number 7 is actually a junction point. And again, as you can see, the line number 8 is another scene point. So this is a control flow graph. So before starting control flow testing, we draw a control flow graph like we have drawn here, and from this control flow graph we will do the white box testing in the perspective of control flow by writing test cases. So stay tuned for the next lectures.